Hey guys, and welcome back to another episode of EverQuest Old School. And on tonight's episode, I am joined by a very good friend. We have Hydros Inc. with us.
What's up, everybody? I'm playing Kithis, my level 18 mage. I think he's 18. Let me take a look at that, actually.
And we're playing our erudites, guys, and that's, you know, very, very cool. You know, like, how often does that happen? Almost like we're getting the Bash Brothers back together with the Barbarians, so.
Five heads, baby. Five heads. Heck, these guys are freaking awesome, dude. I love my mage. My mage is one of the more, how do you say that? One of the funner classes.
More enjoyable. Yeah,
I love the fact that he's got so much power. He can solo mobs. I mean, I've been soloing yellow mobs with him every once in a while, and either I kick the yellow mob's ass, or I have to run. But I barely have to run. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
I mean, so the mage is he's a super tough class. As long as my spells don't get resisted, I'm a really, really powerhouse.
That's the thing with spells, man. But at least you have your pet as backup, so I mean, you can still get a little bit of like run distance on that one.
Exactly, I can run away.
Bye, pet. I miss you. You know,
I'm one of those people who I'm funny about that, man. I hate to see my pets die. It bothers me, and I don't know why that is. I don't know why. You know, I mean, because. Really, when you think about it, it's just a pixel. But you know, he served me faithfully, dude. He's my friend and my companion.
Yeah, and that's what happens when you molest your pet like that. You become attached to it, and it just becomes like you know this thing you don't want to see gone. You know, but
I should not to talk about that on the stream. Like nobody knows that I'm sexually attracted to chickens.
I'm surprised it's not sitting in your lap right now, just kind of floating up there, bouncing up and down. Just be like, oh man, so. Yeah.
I do need to take him over here and have him guard, so hit people from the back.
I do like the look that you got going on. Ooh, we got a gnoll coming.
Oh, what's up? Oh, he's such a wuss, though, dude. He's such a little wussy guy.
Is he green?
Yeah, he's green. Is he green to you?
Yep. He's definitely not giving experience. Okay. And we get faction for killing these guys over here, and a chance at the scalp. So I think we're going to do one to the other, right? Alphabetical, but there's only two of us, so.
I think that that erudites start off with generally a neutral outlook on life too. I think we're okay. I'm gonna pull this guy. Never mind. We got a soothsayer right here. What's up, soothsayer?
Baby, where are you at? Did you back it up?
Got him. All right, yeah. Come on, bring him back here. Pull him back here and pull him to. Oh wait, yeah.
Oh, a brawler. All right. Let me go ahead and root the brawler.
All right. I'm going to try and back my pet off and get him on the soothsayer, who I'm going to start nuking.
All right, same here. Oh, we got... Oh, crap. Zone it.
Zone.
Woo, where did those come from? I can't see anything. Am I still going the right way?
Yeah, you're fine. Go. We have Mugtail, dude. We got aggro from the flame pole up on the ledge. So maybe we need to go out to the other side. Maybe we need to invis past the gnolls and go to where we normally sit. Out there at the end of the trail where the gnolls roam and fight the guard and stuff?
Yeah, that might be a better idea on that one. Definitely, we got some aggro on that.
Yeah, I mean, dude, I have nothing to heal you with. Do I even have... I can summon bandages, so let me bandage you up.
Let me bandage you. And then
I was going to say, your guy is looking pretty good, man. He got the little beer steins on him and, you know, definitely has that so glow thing going on with the hat, man.
Soul glow.
Let your soul glow.
All right. summon Heatstone. I don't need that. Summon bandages. There you are.
Well, you were just saying that it's freezing cold where you're at, so wouldn't you love to be able to summon a Heatstone, just be able to hold that? Oh,
God, yeah, dude. Just something. if they would just put an enclosure out here. If they would just put it in, or they have a big glass part of the library that they can close both the doors. If they just keep the glass partition open and let people sit inside, that there's all kinds of things they could do to make my life more comfortable. But that's just me being, I'm cold. It's only like 34 or 33 degrees out here. It's not like it's sub-zero temperature.
It's just only 34. I mean, like that only happens here when like hell freezes over. But you know that's.
I'm being a whiny little pussy, though, is what it is. This is not that cold, dude.
For some people, maybe. For us, we'd be closing down the city and be like, yeah, that ain't gonna happen.
It's time to stay inside!
People would be breaking out their jackets for real. Like, it's crazy here because it's funny when other people come to town and they're like, it's only 80 degrees, and everybody's walking around with, like, giant leather jackets on. It's because they sit in your closet for the whole year, sometimes multiple years, before you even get to wear them once. And so anytime it even remotely gets cold, people get to, you know, pull out that that clothing that they've been like, oh, I really want to wear that.
Now, AC, let me ask you a question. Do you have any shout-outs? Do you, is there anybody you want to give a shout-out to at this particular time?
No, I mean, I have been getting some messages from people in-game, but I tend to like to respond to them myself rather than do a shout-out on the video, although I definitely appreciate everybody who sends me a message, guys. It's kind of hard to figure out what to say because I am just a guy playing EverQuest. I don't consider myself doing anything that all that special other than that I like playing with the guys and the friends that I have on here, and I love the community that's here. So when you guys tell me you enjoy the videos, I will definitely let you know I appreciate that. And I usually ask you, you know, how's your experience going on YouTube, but beyond that, what do you do? Like, what is the appropriate, you know, I look at like these movie stars out there who seem to be able to have these people come up to them constantly and they're just like, hey, you know, I love your movie. And it's like, what do you say to that? Like, I'm not a movie star.
I'm glad you're a movie star, bro.
And that's what I'm saying. Awesome. Like, I'm not a movie star. Like, I don't know how to respond to any of that stuff when people are like, I like your videos. I'm like, oh, thank you. I appreciate it.
I give people shout outs, man. I mean, like right now, I want to give Drukpa a shout out. Drukpa sent me some tales earlier, guys. He told me he loved mine and AC and everybody's videos, dude. He loved videos. He loved our interactions. He loved our, you know, our playing off of each other and having a good time. He, you know, he enjoys that. And so, you know, I mean, if you go out of your way, guys, you know, I don't know if it's even going out of your way. You're just sending me a tale and let me know you appreciate the videos. I appreciate you guys. I do, man. That's the reason I do this, is because I want to share my love of video games with all of you out there. So if, you know, if one of those ways I can give back to you as a community is give you a simple shout out, if you hit me up in a game that you love and then we share a common interest in, I'm going to try my best to do that. Now, it's easy for me to do that in EverQuest because they have, you know, they have the note system. So you want to invis up? You got CNVIS invisible, or are you just going to run through there? And
I don't think I have a vision. I was just looking to see if that guy was still up.
All right, cool. All right, I'll believe you.
Invis. Oh, I do got invis. Okay.
You put. Okay, I mean, I got tails, dude. Yes, to the left.
You want me
to the right of the bridge. Do you have CNVIS?
I don't think I do, but I can give you regular invis.
If you want to give me invis, I'll give you CNVIS.
So I don't think we need it.
Well, you know, I mean, it's going to make you feel wobbly. Oh my god, never mind. I can't cast fucking CNVIS because I fizzle too much. Yay, there you go. Yay! Okay, invisibility? Yeah. Dude, you gain health back really fast, dude. What's up?
I'm a wizard, dude. I have, like, no health to begin with.
So, would you say that you're a wizard Harry? Is that something you would say?
I would say I'm a hairy wizard.
I don't know. We look kind of smooth, man. Our ebony skin shining in the midnight.
That's because you can't see underneath this robe. Like, if you pop this thing off, I'm like a Yeti underneath it.
Like a Wookiee?
I'm part...
I can't do a Wookiee yell, dude. I've always wanted to, but yeah, I can't.
I can't do it either. I'm part Robin Williams underneath this sucker. But you're going too far, dude. You're going too far. Over here. Yeah, this is pretty much as far as we need to go.
Oh, yeah, this is where we're going, dude. That's right. I was going all the way to the orcs for some reason. So, all right, let me get a pet, dude, before death.
I'm just looking around. Is
everything dead?
I think
how the hell is everything dead?
I think when they trained us, they walk off.
They trained the guards, yeah. Yeah. Nah, that's great. Oh, well, I just summoned a weapon for a pet that I don't have. That's awesome.
But is it awesome, dude?
You know, it is awesome. It's kind of awesome, right?
Now,
I mean,
now you said you love your pet, man. Now, what's the most enjoyable thing about the class you're playing right now?
The interaction with me and my pet, playing off of him, using his yo-yo pet, finding out, oh god, I'm blind.
Oh god, no! Why am I blind?
Oh, he's hitting you hard, man.
Oh, is he? Well, that's great, dude.
You're down to 70%?
Oh, dude. I am down to 76. Holy crap. Why'd you let me die, dude? That's not cool.
I was going to heal you, but then I remember I'm playing my cleric.
Oh, sorry. We were talking about Solgo, dude.
Yeah.
I love that movie, dude. Coming to America is one of the funniest freaking movies of all time, dude. It's got to be, right?
You know, it's up there for sure, yeah. I definitely love watching that one. I like the scene where he goes into the barbershop, you know, and they're all talking. And they're just being themselves, you know, having a good time.
That's
all
Eddie Murphy, too, except for one of them played by that late Arsenio Hall. Yeah, mm-hmm. I used to watch his show, dude. It's freaking amazing. Freaking amazing. They just know the truth there. He doesn't want to die, dude.
Did Arsenio Hall pass away, man?
Yeah, he's dead now. No, I don't know. He disappeared from the spotlight, that's for sure.
It's like, he was kind of young. I mean, you know, he wasn't really...
Yeah, I don't think he passed away, dude. I think he just stopped being famous, maybe?
Do the little hand symbol in the air, man. Woof, woof, woof.
Yeah, yeah. That's why you used to watch the show, dude. It was a large ringmail belt, dude. You know about it? Oh, a newbie giveaway. That's right, dude.
Heck yeah.
Okay, let me give my pet my other freaking thing that I summoned for him, but never got a chance to give him because I was molested by a Noel Soothsayer.
I'm a champion.
Champion is a star dog champion, yeah. He's a star dog, baby.
This guy's had some hit points on him. Yeah, he's rude.
Why the frick can't I target
man.
This
These guys are resisting like crazy, dude.
Ooh, yeah, they're tank mobs, dude. Wow, booyah! He didn't resist that, though, dude. So what's your big nuke hitting for, dude?
117.
All right, let the pet build up a little aggro, then just back up, dude. He should be. I already root him. Yeah, root him. That's a good thing. Yeah, because the pet ain't scared of him, dude. Pet ain't never been scared, dude.
Oh, here comes another one.
Yay, that's what we want.
Let me root the shaman. Probably not the best place to shoot rooted, but there you go.
I'm just gonna burn this knoll to the ground, dude.
Yep, same here.
The champion. The champion's going to die, Cletus. Okay, I believe the pet will be okay against the shaman. We do need to do more than half the damage, or he's going to steal XP from us, because he's a little bad. Oh, God.
Oh, crap. I am down to 9%.
Well, the shaman's dead. We got the brawler, no problem. So, yeah, shaman's dead. Brawler's next. Pet's a little hurt. Ain't nothing I can do about that, except for... Well, I don't even have the mana to chain cast another pet, so you know, just if you get a nuke, definitely send it to the brawler.
He's still at night. Yeah, we need to run it, man. Come on, let's go.
I don't want to run it, dude. Come on.
Got to.
There should be a guard right around the corner too. So
sometimes, but he's not here right now.
Oh no, I'm gonna renew elements, dude. We're gonna live.
All right.
Bam. No, we're not gonna live. That only gave me 28. What the hell? What the hell, Cletai? You know what? I'm going to go make a difference in my pet's life.
You going to melee it? You going to take some damage for them?
I'm going to do it, dude. I'm going to do it.
All right.
I'm going to hit him with my cup.
Oh, of course.
I'm
going
to let his soul go.
When you're low on mana, you always fizzle, guys. Always. That's the way it works.
it's the only way to live, dude, in this world of ours. And yeah, that's enough of that. All right, let's see if I have... Oh, I do have another renew element, dude. This is going to be a squeaker.
All right, he's at 12%. We got it.
Oh, yes! Oh, that's a five-head power right there, baby.
Heck yeah, man. What'd you say yours hitting for? Your max damage?
94 points of damage for my nuke?
It's not too bad, not too bad.
I'm sure you're probably doing about 150 somewhere around there, dude.
Nah, it's 112 or something. Let me look. 119.
That's not bad.
All right, so I'll take the first scalp that we have seen, and if you want to grab the next one. Wrong.
Oh, yeah, it's whatever. It's whatever, dude.
Silk, alright.
Okay, there's Kanye, the person who wanted to join us, man, if you want to give them an invite.
Oh, yeah, sure. Champion, watch out, man.
Oh, hey, what's up, champion? Oh, my pet is not ready for this, dude.
Nope, not even remotely. Alright, he's rooted. You can back up your pet if you need to.
I think I'm going to. So, I don't know if he'll stay back, though. That's the thing. Guard.
He should.
He might. No.
Bunch. How many spots?
I've got the heals to pay the bills, so I think he's going to survive through the night, dude.
And for those of you who maybe have never camped the gnolls over here, guys, you have about 8 to 9 spawns in this area, and they seem to, the ones at least down on the bottom, will walk over towards this area on their own. The ones at the top, they take a little bit longer if they walk over at all, but there is a name that spawns right up that little ramp that you definitely want to kill if you get a chance to. He drops that tomahawk.
Takes a tail. And he drops a shield, yeah. Really nice shield, dude.
Insufficient mana. All right.
If you wish...
Yeah, Pet is, well, you're not too low. You're at 43%.
What's the, he's at 43%, the champion?
No, no.
Oh, yeah, Pet's going to die, dude.
Oh, yeah, Pet is about to die. Let me root it again, because I think it wore off. Back your Pet up.
Yeah, he doesn't care, dude. He's going to die. He's giving his life. He's giving his life for the cause.
All right, let me hit him, see if I can save him, maybe. Oh.
No.
Oh, and he resisted. Of course you did. You're a little punk.
All right, let's see if I got a nuke in, man. Nope. No nukes.
Here he comes. Who's he going after? Enchanter? All right, there he goes. He's rooted, guys. He's rooted. How much mana does it take you to cast another one?
30%. 30%. I don't have enough mana.
I'll hit him as soon as I can with something. He's at 7%, so we just need a tiny bit more damage. I think the enchant... Yeah, there we go.
Oh, there he goes.
Alright, let's back this sucker up a little bit. And you guys, remember to loot those things and see if we can get another skin. We'll take turns on those. Those are fairly good on experience, especially at this level, but the main reason for getting those guys is faction. Faction or money. If you don't need them for yourself, sell them to other players. You know, evil races love to come over here and get those so that they can actually, you know, bank in more places than just one. I did that with my lizard. Took a long time killing mobs before he was even able to turn these things in, but once he was, he went from being kill on sight to almost being allied with these guys with just, I think it was like 7 or 8 stacks, which, you know, is a lot, but.
Well, at least my Pet took a few with him, dude.
Yeah, he did. You know? If we hadn't gotten that ad, I think they would have been more than fine.
Into Valhalla! There we go. So, dude, what's your favorite part of the past, dude? Do you have a favorite part of the past? Do you have a place that when you come up here, I mean, you really like to camp about more than, yeah, you know?
Yeah, it wasn't really gnolls that I experienced more often than anything else. It was orcs, guys. Coming into that area and immediately being run out. You get run out over here on this side too, but the orcs, they are always a little bit harder than the gnolls were, but they were always camped. And I love the fact that you can come in there, you can get a group, you can get your first weight reduction backpack, which was my first experience in items that people were like, this is a camp. This is where we are sitting because we want to get those names. And then the name would spawn, and you know, your group might be kicking the orcs' butts, but then that guy would spawn, and you're just not able to actually take him out on occasion. And that was another first for me, to be able to see a name being so strong and yet have such good rewards if you're able to kill him. Oh, we got another.
Oh, jeez.
I think he might. Yeah, he might be able
to. Oh, you charmed him. Excellent, dude. Yeah.
There we go. But yeah, I mean, that that area over there is very much kind of just what I think of when I think of High Pass. One other area I would mention, guys, is when you go a little bit further in, right when you get towards the entrance to High Keep, there is a little cubby hole that if you turn the wrong way, if you turn left instead of going right and up the hill to the entrance, you will find three little guys inside this little kind of, I don't know, hidden area, and they will attack you. And they're the only ones who will attack you over there, even if you're good, and the guards will not help you. So that is something I remember, because I think I died from that my very first time going in there with my cleric and just getting wrecked like 4 inches away from the zone line and not being able to make it.
That's awesome.
Yeah, it's horrible because your guards are there. You're like, where are you guys at? Why aren't you helping me? But yeah, there's some pretty cool places in the zone that are very memorable. What about you, man? What do you think is the number one?
It was definitely, you know, I was going to say the same thing. No camp, dude. My dark elf, I remember my dark elf, he went from Orc Camp 1 in Eastern Commons. I think after that, it was Oasis, and then it was High Pass, guys. Now, I was playing at a time before there were, you know, before there was Kunark. I remember that. There were no other places to go, except it seemed like everybody went in that linear progression that lived over here. You know, the people, the Dark Elves, and the Trolls, and the Gnolls. I mean, the High Pass was full of those people. And, you know, of course, there were some people with their High Elves and Wood Elves, but you saw a lot more Dark Races back then. I remember that clearly, guys.
Yeah.
And, you know, I was in the Age of Apocalypse. It was, I forget what, sir, I think it was Claws of Ishan, something like that. Oh, and, you know, I apologize for that. That's probably somebody calling to see if I want a warranty. So let's turn the phone all the way off, guys. because of Idiocy, which I am. Idiocy, is that a thing? That's not a thing, dude. Sorry.
It could be. I mean, I'm going to go ahead and give this pet all the junk we pick up because reasons, guys. Somebody's going to get a nice little gift.
You know how we've started talking like Sorkin did?
He's a bad influence, guys. You know,
he is. I love Sorkin.
Sow instead of so, and
yeah, that's bad. That's just bad craftsmanship right there, dude. Mm-hmm. Let your soul go. No, he's very entertaining, man. I love watching his podcast and stuff like that, his YouTube videos and stuff like that. And, now, did you want to talk about the news you had concerning that?
I don't know what news you're talking about, dude.
Okay, yeah, man. I mean, you know, things like... You know,
secrets, guys. Secrets. Yeah. You guys will find out. No, I'll let you guys know. Sorkin did contact me and asked me to be on his stream, hopefully here in the next couple weeks. So if you guys are watching this video on Thoom's channel or on mine, definitely pay attention to Twitch, guys, and go check it out because I think that's going to be really fun to do. I've been watching his stream since I started playing on P99. Just because when I found out there was a GM that was doing streams and helping people with information about the game, I was like, oh, that's kind of cool, right? I can check that out for that reason alone. And then I found out that he's actually really good at what he does, and it was very entertaining, and just kind of became a watcher for that reason alone. So, you know, you can find out tons of really interesting facts from him and have a good time doing it. And I think that is... the main reason for, you know, any kind of YouTube channel or Twitch channel trying to do that, and he pulls it off very well. So hopefully we can get Hydros Inc. in there, maybe some of the other guys at some point in the future, because that would be kind of cool, man. Get the whole gang in there.
Yeah, I work all day Mondays, guys. I would love to be a part of that, man. Like I said, Sorkin is someone I enjoy. I enjoy watching the YouTube videos he puts out. I don't get a chance to actually watch his Twitch and stuff like that, because usually about Sunday, about 3 or 4 o'clock, I'm home. I'm relaxing with my family. It is one of the times that I do spend time with my family. We just recently got internet, guys, and our internet is HughesNet, so we can't watch YouTube videos. We can't watch streams and stuff like that because it uses too much data. We only get 10 gigs a month. It's we have to watch it. So I don't get the chance, but I always download his Twitch videos, his YouTube videos, and I take them home and I watch them, and I really enjoy watching Sorkin's content. And the fact that one of my friends is going to be on one of his podcasts is really cool. I'm really excited about that, man. And like I told you, make sure he makes a video of that, dude, so I can, you know, I can watch it. I want to see that. Harass him until he does it, dude, okay?
Yeah, you know, be like, Sorkin, you're doing this, man.
Do it, Sorkin, do it.
I'll tell you how to do it on your own stream.
That's the only thing he ever responds to is harassment, dude.
I know ZK loves telling him happy birthday. I'm not really sure why, but he gets a kick doing it. So I think Sorkin, last time he heard him, he was like, thank you, and just kind of
I mean, Sorkin seems to, you know, I know he puts up with a lot of crap, a lot of unhappy people, and he just handles it with a grace. You know, he's I think he's magical. I think he has to, man.
I mean, think about it this way, man. You're a GM. You're kind of like the customer service of the server. So you're the first person people see. Now, nobody's paying any money to be here, so he doesn't necessarily have to be nice, because there's no way he can get fired. But even with that said, any experience I've ever had with the GMs, whether it's Sorkin or some of the other guys, in fact...
Oh, God.
Holy crap. Why is he dying? Where's he at?
Oh, because I think his pet broke. Oh, where's he at, dude? He must have
ran to the guards.
Let me go bind his wounds. Which way did he run?
I'm hoping he ran the right way.
I don't see him.
I don't see him at the entrance.
I don't see him. Thanks for asking.
Oh, man, he just died. All right, well, I'll bring my cleric over here. Where's my cleric? I think he's in East Common Tunnels.
Do you need me to log on to Corvallis and come get you, sir?
I should be able to run him over.
All right, I can get you to EK, man. You know that. You know that that's where everybody wants to... That's where the cool crowd is, dude. Oh, no. Nobody's in EK, dude. What am I talking about? Mole Scout. I'm going to loot it. I'm going to loot it because... is it your turn?
No. We both got to. Okay, so let me log out here. be very, very careful, man. Let me get my cleric.
Yeah, I'm going to try and solo these guys until you guys get back. I don't really see any other reason.
Find his corpse if you can and bring him back so I don't have to look for it over here because I don't know where he died. I was looking for him. He's not here, but he's not too far away.
So, nah. Oh, I gotta add.
Be careful. They are very, very rough mobs over here, apparently, at our level. And the gnolls, by the way, guys, are the lesser of the two evils here in this zone. So if you can't take on gnolls, you probably will not be able to take on the orcs.
Yeah, you want to stay away.
And the orcs, not only are they a little tougher because you get a lot more casters. Oh, what's going on? You gonna die?
He was in troll illusion, dude, and the guards killed him.
Oh.
Yeah. Instead of helping him, the people he ran to, sacrificed him to make a better, brighter high pass.
Yeah, I think he went to Troll Illusion because you get that regen, right? That health regen?
Yeah. Oh.
Yeah.
I just own that champion, dude. He was not such a champion, dude. He's not such a Stardog champion. You know what I'm saying?
I wonder how do those illusions work? Because I know if you don't have faction with somebody, you put that illusion on, you immediately get faction with them. What if you have faction with them and you put that illusion on? Do you lose all that faction?
I don't know. I guess so. Yeah, the illusion becomes not a thing that you can depend on. But I mean, the illusion becomes your faction. Yeah. So if you're a troll, I mean, I know it allows you to, like, as a skeleton, you can get inside of, Nariag. You can walk around. All the necromancers won't kill you and take your life, and they'll love you and be your friend. And, oh man, you know.
I see our little guy over here, man.
Little guy.
You know, the guy I'm about to raise, our enchanter.
Oh, you found him? See,
he's right. No. I mean, he's over here at the tunnel, dead, naked.
Does he know you're going to give him a res?
He should, because we said so.
Yeah, I'm lost. Oh, there you are, Zarekker. I was worried about you, dude. You were standing guard back there, and I got lost. I'm lost, guys. I'm lost again.
Don't you have one that can summon?
Summon what?
Your pet?
No. What are you talking about, summon?
You don't have a spell that summons your pet to you?
No, there's no such thing, dude.
I could have swore you did, man.
Let me check. That could be a thing. Identify, Eye of Zom, Invisibility, Phantom Leather, Column of Fire, Summon Staff. No, I don't think this is such a spell, dude.
Okay, well, I thought there was because, there definitely is one in EverQuest 2, but that doesn't mean anything for EverQuest 1. But could have swore there was one back in the day.
I looked, dude. I looked, and I didn't find one. But that doesn't mean there isn't one. Now, there might be something I get at a later level or something like that. But, Dieter?
Hey, man. We know, guys. Do you hear what I am saying? Yes, I understand the words that are coming out of your mouth.
You don't have to keep asking.
Like the Butters. Was it Butters or was it
it was Butters,
Timmy?
Yeah, Butters. At the pimp, yeah. He was pimping large, living life, the large pimp-like structures.
I do know what you mean.
You do not have to keep asking. I love Butters, dude.
Yeah, but Butters is... it's crazy because Butters is like your normal kid growing up with like abnormal kids and somehow not being affected by it as much as you might think they would be. Except, you know, he does have a split personality. He is Captain Chaos. Or Professor Chaos. There you go.
Yeah, Professor Chaos is really, really cool. Really cool aspect.
I love it when he tries to flood the valley or whatever that they live in.
He's got the spigot outside on the water hose.
For like 3 days straight. I want to know where his parents are.
The creators of South Park, dude, are just geniuses, man. They make me, you know, almost every episode never fails to make me horse laugh in some way, dude. So it's definitely a show I still have a lot of love for. And the thing I really, really like about South Park, guys, is they have their own website, and you can watch the episodes that are new 3 days after they are new on their website. I don't even know if they have any advertisements or something like that on, but you can go and watch their new content 3 days after they make it. And, you know, so that's freaking awesome. That's awesome.
Yeah, I think so. I mean, that shows that they're not just in it for the money. I think they probably made plenty of money by now. They've been on the air for, who knows, what is it, like 17 years now or something? And the last I looked, the season that they were on?
Oh, yeah. Huh? What?
South Park? seasons?
Yeah. How many? Dude, I don't know. I think it's 20 or 21 or something
Wow.
like that.
Wow. Okay. Well, then, yeah, even more money than I would have assumed. So, although you know, I did like some of their movies. Basketball was really good. They did have some disgusting scenes in it, where he's drinking the lard, and you know, he's like, oh, I just had a liposuction. I'm like,
they kissed each other, guys. I'm not a homophobe, guys, but that. They were so into it, man. It made me so uncomfortable. I was like,
The worst part of watching that movie is their weird sense of humor. I thought in the back of my head, there's a good chance that is actually lard that somebody's got sucked out of their stomach that he's drinking right there. Cause
shut up,
I can see them doing it. I can see them doing it. And I'm like, oh, man. I'm gonna find out later on. That's real stuff, you know.
It certainly looked real, dude. I remember exactly what you're talking about, dude. That's so gross, dude. But that's why I love them, dude, because they have that power. They have that ability to just totally gross you out, man.
Yeah.
That's a skill. It's a marketable.
But they
skill.
don't just gross you out for the sense of like, oh, it's a bunch of spiders, scary, ooh, grossy. No, they do it in a funny way. And they only do it every so often. You know, like in that movie, those two scenes that we're talking about, those are pretty much the only thing. I only see one scene in that movie that really just that liposuction scene. But everything else is just them, you know, cracking jokes and having fun and pretty much ripping on that one little small guy. For what was his name? Tweak or?
Oh yeah, I remember that, dude. Okay, we're outside of the high hole, dude. So when you come in and you come to Rez, we're outside here, dude.
You're outside a high hold. Oh, you had to zone out?
No, we're out in front of the keep, dude.
Okay.
Yeah, his corpse. Yeah, his corpse is out in front of the keep.
All right, that shouldn't be too far away. I got Spirit of Wolf on, and I'm going right through Kith as soon as I zone in. So.
I you know, I hate to watch people die, dude, but sometimes people die in this game, dude, especially when, you know,
like you
we
said,
don't have a healer. We don't have a healer.
Yeah.
So, you know.
I'll give you guys buffs when I get there. Plus, like he said, you know, it wouldn't have happened had he not forgotten that, you know, trolls are not welcome in High Pass, so.
Yeah. I mean, he might have lived a little bit longer.
Well, he made it to the guards. So if he hadn't been in that illusion, the guards would have helped him and killed the mobs, and he would have been fine. So it's kind of a hard lesson, but, you know, he's not going to lose too much experience. We're going to get him a 96% res and get some cleric buffs on both you and him. And I think in the end, that's going to help out quite a bit, you know, because you're going to add another, 300-400 hit points to each one of you with just Heroic Bond alone. And what do you have right now as far as hit points go?
On my little Kithas?
Mm-hmm.
357 and, 357.
So we're going to be doubling it pretty much for you.
Yeah, also, you're going to give me some buffs? Hell yeah, dude. Actually, I'd rather you give my pet some buffs since he's going to be tanking for us, dude.
I'll give him some buffs, but the problem with that is your pet's low, and there's only so many spells I can give a low level, so.
Okay, well, you know, there we go. I mean, you know what I'm saying?
I give him, like, resolution and shield of words or something, but.
Everyone knows it's butters. Let's see. So I need to log in my breakfast, which was 2 granola bars. Let's do that, yeah, because it's bugging me. It's going to keep bugging me. And I don't like when people bug me because I'm, you know, unbuggable. Or I'm actually really buggable.
Now, did you get to see the Halloween event at all?
No. Did you get to view footage of that?
Yeah, I recorded the whole thing from start to finish.
Oh, very nice, dude. Crap.
Yeah,
have you released it yet?
I think it is, yeah. I think it was a stream that I did, so I just put it straight up onto YouTube. The only reason I was going to ask is so I could get your opinion on what you thought of the event, but did you hear what they did for it or no?
No, I haven't heard anything, dude. Enlighten me, my friend.
It was actually pretty cool, man. What they did is you started the quest by going to North Karana's or to Lesser Fedar, so you can go to either one of the continents and start the quest there. And he asked you to go around and help these people that were in the book that they gave you to overcome their fears. And each one of them had a little hint about where they were located. So it would say, you know, such and such person is scared of spiders and they're trying to overcome that fear. They're found in a dark forest next to a river where spiders lurk or something along those lines. And if you read it closely enough, you could figure out that, oh, they're talking about Nariak, a very specific part of Nariak as well. And you would know where to go to find that NPC, which I think takes a little bit of effort to do because you're trying to keep it vague, but not too vague that people familiar with the game will still be able to get it. So there was 12 locations in the book, and then there was an additional 4 bonus questions or bonus guys that you can go and scare as well. But they were in Viz, so you needed like a group to go through and get all these people. We did it as a group for the guild and for some of our friends that were in there with us. We teleported. You need a druid. It definitely helped. Having a bard helped with the speed as well. And then, of course, having a cleric was really nice because some of the places they told you to go to, guards did not like you at all. And they changed you into a different illusion. So you could be a werewolf, you could be a specter, you could be a ghost, or you could be a scarecrow.
Very cool. Very cool.
And at the very end, they gave really, really good rewards, guys. So, you know, I think they have refined their technique on what they were doing with it. And they gave candy corn away, and the candy corn had amazing stats, so...
Oh, yeah, by the way, Sirkin, I appreciate you doing it on the night that I couldn't participate. Thanks for that, dude.
Oh, thanks, yeah, buddy. Man, you know.
Screw you guys, I'm going home.
There's a small group over there at Orcs.
Oh, well, you know, hey, groups are at Orcs sometimes, dude.
No, yeah, I'm just saying, like, it seems like there's only 2 or 3 guys there, but we might be able to form up and group with them.
You like, the Megazord? We could form into the Megazord?
Yeah, with these powers combined, I am Captain Planet.
I mean, I'm open to that, dude. As long as they got room for 3 people, dude. That's sounds like a thing, buddy. All right, I'm going to rape this champion from the backside, guys.
Ooh,
watch this.
Ooh, I think that's illegal, dude.
Oh, yeah. Oh, he liked it, dude. He liked it.
I think the guards in Kinos might have a problem with that.
He's like my booty hole. My booty hole. My booty hole. Speaking of booty holes, guys, today I was really giving it to some Draugrs on my Skyrim Special Edition playthrough. You know, I'm having such a fun time with that. Definitely want you guys to go watch that if you get the chance. Appreciate it, baby. Wow. All
right, come back over to the entrance, man. I'll buff you guys up.
Yeah. No. I mean, give me a second. I got to kill this champion, dude, because he thinks he's a champion when in all reality, I am the champion.
I am the champion, my friend.
Booyah!
You gotta do it in a deep voice, like Bear from Armageddon.
And we'll be together till the end.
Not quite as deep.
I can go deeper, dude. That's what she said.
Dun, dun,
dun. Or is that what she said, dude? I don't think that's what she said, actually.
She might have.
She could have. So that's a real possibility. What's up, Miss High Pass Citizen? How you doing? Oh my god. Oh my god. Shadden, what are you doing, Shadden?
Toss me an invite, man.
Oh, did Kanye die again? Oh yeah, invite incoming. Am I the leader?
Somebody is.
I don't want to be the one that sucks the Peter, dude. That's what the leader does, dude.
All right, let's
man, he's
up.
A man. If he can't do it, no one can. Hey, Cletus.
Oh man, but guys, I think we're gonna go ahead and end the episode here. We're gonna med back up, get everybody buffed up, and on the next episode we're gonna continue on with killing the gnolls over here, see if we can get some experience, maybe even be able to group up with the guys over there at the orcs and get a full-blown group going on, because all we really need is a tank. We got the DPS, so hopefully that is going to be a thing here fairly soon. But as I said before, guys, if you were watching on my video, make sure to check out my friends Hydros Inc. You want to tell them a little bit about your channel, man?
Yeah, guys, I have a YouTube channel and sometimes a Twitch.
And there you go.
Yay!
Yeah, he puts out a lot of EverQuest videos, guys. Oblivion, Fallout 3, all sorts of really good stuff from time.
Fallout 3, I stopped playing, dude, because nobody watched the video. The thing that I want to, I already plugged it, dude. My Skyrim Special Edition, guys, it's a blast. I'm actually going to start modding it. There is a mod that gives you Space Marine armor, 40 in the 40K universe. It gives everybody Space Marine armor, and I'm a big fan of the 40K Warhammer universe. So, chicken?
Yeah. And, That would be really cool. Yeah, I can't wait to see that, man.
It's gonna be a blast from the past.
And until next time, guys.
Subscribe.
Hey guys, and welcome to the disembodied voice of AC Gamer. We are definitely going to be doing a lot more series in the future, but here are a few of them that you guys might find interesting. Of course, you're more than welcome to check them out. I would love to hear your comments. Again, if you do enjoy these videos, be sure to hit that like button, subscribe. It's definitely the indicator that I use to tell if you guys want to see more videos like that. of that particular game style, of that series in the long run. So when you guys leave comments down, it helps me decide whether we should keep doing it, as well as whether you want to see games like that in the future. And here are a few of them right here. I kind of picked out a few of different genres. We will be doing spotlights for other YouTubers in the future. So if you want to get a little shout out, definitely let me know. If you group with me, chances are you will get a shout out in here eventually. But for now, these are just four series that I have that I feel like could use a little bit more attention, and that you guys might actually enjoy as well. Thanks again for watching, guys, and we will definitely catch you all next time.